Remember this? Where should we go next? Let us know in the comments below. Madrid would have been nice, but it's slightly out of our budget. Thank you anyway for the suggestion, Alexander. Yeah, we actually went to Madrid. So we thought that why aren't Real Madrid doing as well this season narrative was a bit too broad, but we did look into their main man up front, Karim Benzema.
That's right, tonight we make our first European expedition and we're in Madrid where we're going to ask Real Madrid fans if they still think Karim Benzema is the right striker for them.
¿Cree usted que Benzema sigue siendo el 9 para el Madrid?
No.
No.
Ahora mismo no.
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 No. Claramente no.
Benzema is not good for the moment.
Personalmente no me gusta Benzema.
No, yo creo que necesitamos un cambio este verano. Benzema marca muy pocos goles. Necesitamos a gente como Icardi o Kane.
Pues ahora sí, porque es el que tenemos.
¿Sigue siendo del nivel adecuado para ser el delantero del Madrid?
Sí, sí.
Por supuesto.
Todavía sí.
Yeah, I think he's right for number 9.
El fútbol de Benzema es mucho más que hacer goles.
¿Qué pasa? Que la gente se cree que es que tiene que meter goles porque lleva el número 9, pero juega bien al fútbol. A mí me gusta.
A mí me gusta, pero este año está fallando, yo este año lo cambiaría ya.
Benzema. Ese está acabado ya.
So the majority of fans seem to think that Benzema's time is up at the Bernabeu, but are they right? Let's put it to the numbers.
There's no harder group of people to please than Real Madrid fans who will settle for nothing less than world-class in their squad. Karim Benzema's place in the team is coming under intense scrutiny, so we asked ourselves, is he still at the level of other elite strikers from European powerhouses? There's a point to be made for Benzema not performing at the level expected of Real Madrid number 9. If we compare his expected goals numbers to those of rival strikers, the Frenchman has by far the lowest expected goals per 90 of them all. Not only this, but his post-shot XG to XG ratio is also the lowest on the list, meaning he's actually detracting from what little chances he gets with below-par finishing. Our performance rating model tells a similar story. With 84, Benzema is by a margin the lowest rated striker on the list for this season. So, are Real Madrid fans conclusively right in slamming the performances of Benzema this season? Here at Football Whispers, we're anything but narrow-minded, so let's see if we can spin this one around and defend the French striker. If we compare Benzema's persona to that of these other elite strikers, we can see that while Benzema is the least characterized by goal-scoring amongst them, he's actually the one whose profile is aligned the most with chance creation, which gives us a hint of where to go looking for his contribution. If instead of looking at XG directly, we look at the XG of shots he's assisted, suddenly his output is much more favorable. It seems that rather than taking the chances himself, Benzema is actually enabling his teammates to take those chances. How else could we measure this hypothesis? An interesting stat to look at is what percentage of the moves a player participates in end with himself, for example by him taking a shot, rather than moving the ball into a different player. Apart from Aguero, Benzema is the striker on the list which ends the lowest percentage of moves he participates in, evidencing the point we've been making. Evidently, Benzema is not having the goal-scoring output of other elite strikers, but we must ask ourselves, in a team that includes Cristiano Ronaldo, is that really his role? Now, I can't presume to know what role Benzema plays in the coach's game plan, but maybe Madrid fans should consider this when they ask for a new striker. So there we have it. Karim Benzema might not be Europe's most potent attacker in terms of goal scoring ability, but he does have a valuable role in terms of creation. Where should we go next? Let us know in the comments below, but in the meantime, this has been 3 Minute Myths, Delusions Debunked in 180 Seconds.